The next in line is Dr. Ramesh. Yes, sir.
Good morning, everybody. The dignitaries on the dais and after dais and my dear students. The integration, since couple of years, we have been repeatedly hearing about the integration of AYUSH to the mainstream. Why this has come into the line? So India, we all know, is a huge country and the second most populous country in the world. Our culture is diverse. We got more than 600 languages. Ethnicities are different. Everything is different. And medical health systems are also, you have got plenty. This is where the problem arises. Even though what is called, plenty amongst the problem is, even though we've got so many systems of medicine, they are not reaching the people. Why? India is a rural-oriented country. 75% of our population live in rural areas, whereas the medical establishments are concentrated mainly in the urban areas. And 11% of the PhDs have no doctors. We've got a shortage of 68% of specialists and 89% of specialists. Why this is happening? This is mainly geographical, inequitable distribution of the health system. This is when the government started thinking about integration. Why? WHO states, every country should have one doctor for 1,000 population. In India, the ratio is one doctor for 1,674 population. How to bridge this gap? Either by opening more medical colleges, by producing more doctors. That's been done, but that cannot be done in a single day or a single year. Or else, the bring in the AYUSH people into the mainstream. If you look at the statistics, India has about 9 lakhs allopathic doctors and about 6 lakhs AYUSH doctors. Most of the allopathic doctors are concentrated in urban areas, and luckily the rural people have been serviced by the AYUSH doctors. How to integrate them? Is not as easy as being said. One thing is the systems are diverse. Each system is diverse. Even then, the advantage, if you integrate a lot of advantages, sir. When a National Medical Council bill was coming up, government tried to introduce the bridge course. It was shelved on the protest of the IMA. The idea of the government was to, by conducting a bridge course, train the AYUSH doctors to treat the minor ailments and to treat the emergency cases in the rural areas, and put a ban and put a what you call this bond of 5 years, so that they will serve only in the rural areas. They will not come into this thing. That's a noble idea. The problem is how to achieve it. Advantages are plenty. If you want to train them, they will be able to treat minor ailments, and serious ailments can be diagnosed at the initial level itself, so that many lives can be saved. And it can revitalize the traditional medicines and develop them. And also it will help us in reaching the World Health Organization parameters. And it will also help us in delivering the health care. But how to achieve it? Because the systems are entirely different. Each has got entirely different principle. Allopathy depends upon the evidence-based medicine. We depend upon the symptoms and science and evidence-based. Whereas the Ayurveda follows the Tridosha policy, Vata, Pitta, Kapha. The homeopathy is similar, kill similar. So how to integrate the system? It's a noble idea. It has to be done. But how to do it? Because basically, once we integrate, it should not lead to the jealousy or rivalry between the systems, which may become counterproductive and which may generate unnecessary, unhealthy rivalry. Without causing rivalry, without causing any heartburn among the people, the integration has to be done. If you do it, a lot of advantages are there. I feel integration has to be achieved by creating mutual respect among the staff. We need to develop the cross-referral system. We should develop an attitude where AYUSH doctors should be able to learn from the expertise of the allopathic doctors, and allopathic doctors should be able to learn from the expertise of the Ayurvedic doctors. When this happens, when this symbiotic relationship develops, then only the integration can be successful. Otherwise, integration can never be successful. When I look at the colleges curriculum undal, even when I look at the dental doctors who are mainly unemployed nowadays, I always wonder, sometimes it may look outrageous, but Darshan Shankar also touched upon that. When I look at the syllabus, allopathic doctors also study for around 4.5 years, Ayurvedic doctors also study 4.5 years, and dental doctors also study for 4.5 years. And when you look at the syllabus, MBBS doctors study anatomy, physiology, and biochemistry in the first year. They study microbiology, pathology, pharmacology, PN in the third year. AYUSH doctors also study anatomy and physiology. Only they don't study biochemistry, but they study pathology, they study preventive medicine, they study forensic medicine. They study the same books. Maybe intensity may be different, but they study the same books. Later on, in the clinical aspect, the things change. Can we accomplish integration at this level so that proper utilization of the manpower can be done? For example, if you teach the AYUSH students and dental students as well as the medical students in a single classroom in the first year, because anatomy is common, biochemistry is common, physiology is common. If the same teacher can teach them, maybe first 2 years of foundation courses, later on when they come to the clinical courses, allopathic doctors can go to the respective hospitals, Ayurvedic doctors can go to their respective Ayurvedic dispensaries, and dental doctors can divert to their dental practice. In this way, two main things will achieve. One is proper utilization of manpower will be done. The same anatomy teacher can teach all the students, same physiology teacher can teach all the streams of medical students. One more thing, most beneficial effect, what I foresee in this method is the camaraderie. Interpersonal relationship between the different faculties will develop. I tell you how. For example, before I became a Senate member, my interaction with other specialty was minimum. When I was elected to the Senate, then I came across many people from the dental background, nursing background, physiotherapy background. We developed mutual respect. We became friends. We started socializing. That barrier has been broken. What I see in this method is integration of the education level, the barrier will be broken. They will study in the same classroom under the same teacher and between the same four walls. This will generate integration. They will develop mutual respect, and they will develop an attitude where they will be able to draw from the expertise of the other. They will respect mutual respect. And once this is achieved, later on, the informed consent of the patients also can be achieved. In the hospital, patients should be given an option. He should be explained for such an illness, which system has a better medicine, which system has what all these things. The patient should be given opportunity so that he can choose which line of treatment he requires. This can be done only if we can achieve the integration at the level of education itself. Thank you. These are my views, and I thank ABP for having given me the opportunity to stand here. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for the brief, straightforward shot at how we can integrate. One point which he made very significant, which we need to pay more attention to, is the rivalry or competition which is unnecessary. Our aims and goals are same. And somehow, from the policy level to whatever level, this seems to be, can you do this? I can do that. What you can do, I can't do. I mean, this is not the thing. How do we do healthcare or whatever it is, whether the patient in focus, country in focus, whatever. We are focusing on our systems more than our objectives or where we need to. Thank you, sir, for bringing it out.